Welcome to the Black Delegates Podcast. This is episode 44. Today's date is December the 10th, 2018. And we are the Black Delegates, I guess. Since we're doing the Black Delegates Podcast, we would therefore have to be the Black Delegates. So we got the crew back together again. If we had a movie, I think Ishmael would be played by LeBron James, because he would have to pick a dude where he could do everything. So it would have to be LeBron James. Paul, mm-hmm. Who would you be in a movie?
I'm waiting for
this. I'm gonna go with the dude from The League. I know you know who I'm talking about.
Oh, that's it.
Yes. That dude is Paul.
That's pretty accurate, actually.
And I think we'll go with Lil Rel can play me. And that can be Black Delegates the movie. Yeah. It's pretty good. So I think we have a blockbuster hit. So any of these Hollywood types, y'all want to give us a call, we can write something up. Yo, for Ishmael the Writer.
Don't get it twisted. I'm not that hairy. I'm not as hairy as Rafi. Come on now.
Yeah, but that dude is exactly you. In every situation.
That's what you want me to be. All right. I got you.
All right. So it's been, I don't know, man. It's been over a week now. It's been a long time. We recording on a Thursday. Paul, I guess first off, our condolences to you and your family.
Right, thank you.
Yeah, if you don't want that in there, I can cut that out. But
We can get into another time. We're not going to get into it now. But yeah. We'll talk about that.
Yeah. We won't get into no details or nothing like that. No. Keep it private. And other than that, how y'all been doing, Ishmael?
Chilling.
How you been?
Pretty good, man.
Chilling?
No complaints. Chilling?
You ready to do a show?
Yes, sir. Been ready. Was born ready.
Okay, I ain't going to say all that. I ain't going to say all that. My energy a little low. I don't know what this is going to turn out as. But we'll see. So let's get into it. Let's see. This week in blackness. I'm going to start off. Start off this week in blackness. That don't mean nothing. Relax. That doesn't mean it's a whole bunch to be said. Let's see what I've been doing this week. Man, I feel like it's been a lot of kindergarten problems going on at the crib. Been trying to stamp out this situation. I know I told y'all about on the group me, what's going on with the kid, my 5-year-old and his first year at school. And it's up and down, man. He seemed like he'll be doing good, and then it'll go back to normal again. I think he probably bored, and I also think his teacher sucks. So I'm not that dude that's out here just blaming the teacher.
Right. Because
I do know my son, so I know what he's capable of. I know he can act a fool sometimes, and he's pretty hyperactive. So I know those issues. But also, his teacher, man. It's her first year, so I think she's coming in with she gonna change the world mindset. So she trying to tighten the screws up, mm-hmm. like real quick. But he's 5, you know, and so are the other kids. Cause she told me, like, you know, it's not just him. Like, it's everybody. Like, yeah, that means it's you. Like, you need to chill. They 5. I'm gonna need the overhaul of the education system. I need them to. These kids got to be outside, man. I understand you going to school for a whole day, cause I work all day, so I ain't got time for that half a day babysitter crap. But I'm gonna need them to get a 4 hours of running around, art, something like that, and then the rest of the day you can learn. But we can't be just going out for recess for 30 minutes. That's not cool when you're a little kid.
They definitely need more than that.
Giving out points in this point system. It's ridiculous. Certain things I don't need to know about. It'll be like, -1 point, got out of his seat. I'll be like, what? Like, do I need to know that? talked out of turn. I don't need to know that. -2. I don't care. You know, I mean, is it really bad? I've talked to her before on the phone, so I'm not just sitting back on the sidelines. But at the same time, it's hard for me to gauge how
I'm
to
give you a -1,000 for this podcast. That's all I know.
Nah, man, it's fine. It's life. Other people, you gonna talk about stuff like that one day too. We sit through and listen to your stuff, Paul.
Oh, you better hear some more in here in a second.
All right. So sure. How was your weekend blackness then, or brownness?
Oh man, look, first of all, I got it's good to be back. I missed the show. I'm always glad to be with you fellas. But yeah, got a ton of stories I can tell for the week in blackness. I'm gonna archive some of these. So I'm gonna roll these out. But yeah, we had a death in the family, so I had to go to a very black funeral and things like that. But the thing I want to talk about, it also relates to teachers. So I'm gonna try to one up your teacher story, Ryan.
Okay.
So you know the teacher I told y'all about back in the day. And I remember I was telling y'all about the time when I had filled out some forms for my kid and it had, you know, the question on race.
Right, right.
And I think I checked like Hispanic and other or something like that, or Hispanic and mixed. And then the lady saw the papers I filled in, like, this is like 6 months later. And she said, she approached my wife, because she always approaches the wife. She never approaches me. Because I look like Rafi, so, you know, people are scared of me. And so she was like, you know, ask my wife like what she is, you know, what's my wife, is she 100% black and stuff like that, and then basically telling me to tell my wife that she's gonna change the forms that I had filled in
right.
on the race of my child, because she thinks it's gonna get him like more scholarships, you know, down the road or something like that. I'm like, okay, and so we were just kind of like, okay, whatever. So this is the same teacher. So this week we got, actually I got to go to this tomorrow. This incident happened a few weeks ago, but the meeting we got to have tomorrow is tomorrow. So we're having like our Christmas party tomorrow at school. And part of the Christmas party is like, there's going to be some speakers there coming for the parents and, you know, just talk about some programs. So it's got kind of like a little parent training in the morning. Then we're going to have like little festivities. Anyway. There's going to be a representative from the local sheriff's office at the thing.
So we
got some cops.
Okay.
We got some
parents. What's that about?
All right, yeah. So here we go, guys. This is gonna be funny. So the lady, so whatever. She kind of mentioned this email. Oh, we're gonna have this sheriff. He's gonna come out and talk about, you know, program, just kind of kid safety, blah blah. No, nothing big, right? Okay, whatever. Anyway, again, this always happens to my wife. My wife is black. She's not really light skinned. Like, it's hard to explain. She's 100% black. She's not 50% black or anything like that. I'm sure there's some mixing, you know, down the road. But her parents are both black. She's got to be darker than your wife, Ryan. She's darker than your wife. But she's just got real straight hair, and I don't know. It's hard to explain her complexion. But she always gets asked a lot, like, is she 100% black? But she's 100% black. But anyway, so this teacher's talking to her, and she's kind of talking to her about this after school one day, and I'm not there. But she's talking to her, and she's talking about cops. How to say this is, you might know what I'm kind of have a better word for this, but they just get a little too familiar with the stuff. So she's talking about this situation where, you know, we're going to have the cop there and stuff like that. And then she kind of starts dabbling into like Black Lives Matter issues and things like that. She's like, you know, with these... With these, you know, these things that are going on in this world, and I want these kids to get in front of the police, and because like your son, I don't know if he's ever, you know, I don't know if he's ever gonna, you know, interact with the cops, but I want him to at least see cops interact with him, because I don't know if he's gonna get darker later on or something like that. And this is where it went, man. So. So I kid you not, she's basically saying, like, you know, her heart's in the right place, but it's just how it all come out. It's just all wrong. And so every time she talks about race with my wife, because every time she's talking about race, my wife, she's always like, because it's a Jewish lady, so she's always like, well, you know, you understand, you know, talking to my wife, and she always kind of throws in like, I don't know what you call that, like a you know, kind of like a sister girl type thing. You're like, you know, like we cool girl, you know what I'm saying? But it's like. Yeah. It's like you're trying too hard, lady. So anyway, but she was
Rachel
saying,
DeLays alone.
Yeah, exactly, right. She means well, I think. She just don't know how to say anything. And I've told my wife, like, do not engage with this lady. Do not engage with her.
She's trying to be an ally.
But anyway, but she's sitting there talking about my son's gonna darken up. And so my wife comes back and tells, like, my wife is offended. So she doesn't say anything. She's kind of like, okay, because she can kind of know the lady a little crazy. And so I'm like, all right, whatever. So she come and tell me when she gets home or whatever like that. And I'm like, how the hell does a 4-year-old kid darken? Like, my kid looks like Erica Estrada up there or something like that. My kid is not going to turn into...
Hey, I have seen a picture of a dude who is dark-skinned at my church who was light-skinned when he was little. So Sosa.
Oh man, it's possible. You think so? You basically say my kid can have the reverse Sammy Sosa? That's what you're saying.
I doubt that happens with your kid. Sosa, he about the same complexion as you for the most part. But yeah, it's possible. It's possible.
My kid, like, even though my wife is darker than me, but she's not that much darker than me, and my kid is like maybe like one shade darker than I am, and I get dark in the sun, but I don't get dark. Man, but anyway, man, it was just ridiculous. So anyway, I'm just sitting there like, okay, you know, and my wife's kind of, she's actually a little upset about it, and I'm definitely upset about it too. But I'm like, it's just like she means well, but she just don't know what to say. You know, she just don't know what to say. And it's not like what's funny is there's two other black families in the class with us too. So it's like I just hope she's not saying the same crazy stuff to them too. But I don't know, probably. Man. That's my week of blackness right there, man. Just dealing with teachers. With mixed race kids, I don't know, man. If you got any experiences like this, let me know. But this is what we're going through right here.
Now, tell your wife, or if you going up there as well, do not let the police fingerprint your son. Because they like to go into schools and get the little kids and be like, oh, let's do fingerprinting. This is fun. And then 10 years later, it's going to implicate him in a crime. Don't do it. No fingerprints.
Now he robbed a bank. Right. Like, but he's six. Like, oh, somebody put 16.
Hey, man. Yeah, I'm gonna be up there every step of the way tomorrow. So yeah, we got a little Christmas party going on. But I'll watch out for this year. I'll report back and let you know what happened, man. What about you, Ish? How was your week?
My week was pretty good. I actually do two things. One, I'll kind of piggyback off of your story because I got something that's a little bit related. So. You guys know during Ferguson when that went down, you know, I was down there. I was doing videos. I wrote a couple articles about it. Yeah. I was involved in the news coverage for that. And so today when I woke up, I'm checking my email, and I got an email from Denmark. And, what? You know, since this whole, what is it, GDPR stuff has gone down where in Europe, they changed the laws to where, like, you have the right to be forgotten. So that blocked a lot of American websites if you're in Europe. Okay. Until you come into compliance with that. But anyway, so this person in Denmark was trying to read an article that I wrote during Ferguson. It's actually a professor. So I'm guessing this professor was presenting it for the class or something. They said, hey, I can't access this story on the website. Could you send it to me? So I went ahead and sent it to them, and, you know, I got professors over in Denmark checking for your boy's work. So
hey, you asked awesome, for a $1,000 check as well?
No. No money. Okay. No money.
No African prince. No African,
right. No African prince. You know, they want to use my text as a teaching tool, you know, and me valuing education like I do. I'm going to go ahead and send it to them at no charge. So that was one thing that was pretty cool today, and it kind of, like I said, tied into what you were talking about a little bit.
That is cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, the second thing, I got to go back to last week's show when I talked about, like, the blackest week ever. I forgot to talk about the blackest thing that happened on that day.
Blacker than riding a bus and then taking a lime scooter to cash your check.
Yes, this was all on the same day. But the blackest thing that happened that day, I forgot to mention. And I was like, man, I got to go back and talk about that. So when I was at the bank that day, I'm coming out after I just saw the old lady arguing with the bank teller and getting ready to scrap. I'm leaving, going to get in my car. And the bank I was at is in the same building where there's a post office. So it's like the downtown post office of St. Louis. So there's a, I don't know, like a parking, it's not really a parking lot, but there's a little parking strip, and cars that want to come and drop their mail off, they go through kind of the same line as if you were going to park or whatever. So anyway, I guess all the parking spots were filled, and there's this one car sitting waiting for whoever had went inside, whether they went to the post office or the bank, whatever, but they're blocking the mailboxes for people to drop off, just drive by and drop off. So they start honking their horn at them because they like, yo, I need to get to this post office box. You blocking it. They start beeping at the dude. So this black dude gets out the car, older guy, and he kind of lets them know, A, the driver's inside. But he got out the car, so I thought when he got out, he's going to just move it. He's going to go walk around to the driver's side, move the car out their way, maybe circle back around or whatever. He got out the car, like motion like they're inside, leaned up against the car, lit a cigarette, like crossed his legs, and just smoked his cigarette and looked at him. And I was hollering.
Crazy.
So, and he didn't move it either. He waited until the people came out and got in his car. So I just thought that was like the blackest thing I done seen that day, where he just got out, smoked a cigarette, and looked back at him like, hey, I don't know what to tell you.
You know what? That ain't black. That's just ignorant. That's like, bro, do you have a driver's license? Because if you do, you need to move that mess.
Hey, he may not have had the keys. I don't know. But it was hilarious watching it.
People don't care no more.
Yep, so that's all I got.
All right. So, today is going to be a freestyle day because we chose not to bring you any black people being mistreated, shot, or killed this week.
Right.
We looked at them. I looked at a couple stories. Ishmael looked at a couple stories, and we said, nah, we don't feel like it. Yeah, so, we out
some,
on that.
Some Christmas cheer.
That's right. It's cold enough outside. We don't need to be depressed. We need some uplift us.
That's a fact. So, let's see. So, what are we going to talk about? I see this internet privacy discussion on here. Ishmael, did you put that on there?
Yeah, I put that on there.
It's pretty highbrow. That can't be Paul. It's got no TNA, so I knew it wasn't him.
Yeah, well, it kind of gets around to that.
Paul's like, I know where I'm going with this one.
Okay.
Paul, who was... like 20 minutes late because he fell asleep, quote unquote.
Quote unquote.
Yeah. These are facts. These are facts, man.
I've been up since like 4 a.m. today, man. So I'm feeling it, fellas. All
right. So let's get to it, Ishmael. So what you want to talk about on this one?
Well, I mean, this can go in whatever direction, but the reason that made me bring it up. Actually saw, I got an email, you know how you get a little spam mail, a little invitations or whatever about a little stuff. So I got this email today that I saw, and it's about a service that you can get to where if you buy something online, we all shop on whatever, Amazon, Walmart, whatever, you do your online shopping, and this service, if you buy something online and the price drops within whatever 30 days or whatever, they will contact the store for you and request your refund. So you don't have to do anything. It's automated. Mm-hmm. They do it for you. So I looked at it and I'm, you know, about to delete it. And I'm like, well, this is kind of weird. Like, what is this? So I dig deeper into it and I see that the catch is that when you install this program, you have to allow them access to read, write, or delete emails. So it basically reads through all your emails looking for receipts.
Right.
And to try to catalog it so it can tell, you know, do a service to find out if you need a refund or not. So that just made me think about internet privacy. For me, though, I'm like, there's no way in the world that I'm doing that. I don't want to give this company access to every single email that I got. I'm not doing it. But I wonder, what do y'all think about that? And then even broader than this specific instance, just what do y'all think about internet privacy in general, like when it comes to shopping and getting personalized ads and all of that?
Go ahead, Paul.
All right, man, you want me to go? Like, so first of all, I believe there is no internet. There is no thing as true internet privacy. Like, look, man, y'all can do all that stealth mode on your phone or that private browse and y'all
incognito taps.
Ain't doing a damn thing, dog. Ain't doing a damn thing. They know what you're doing. Man, look, all I know is internet privacy. Man, I've had my identity stolen or at least potentially stolen. Probably like 4 times in the last like 2 months, because like that Marriott, y'all heard about that Marriott breach, and so I was caught up in that because I've been with Marriott for years. The healthcare company I've been using, the local one here in town, like they had a breach, so I actually got credit monitoring service. I just signed up for literally today for like a year or two of credit monitoring for them.
Dang.
So I have that, and then there was a couple other instances, like just it's like, man, it just happens constantly. Your stuff is not really secure, man. You just got to be diligent about, you know, making sure that, you know, things aren't getting open. And luckily, I've never had it where I've had like credit card, you know, I have like the call from the credit card company saying, hey, are you in Dallas, Texas, making this purchase for a TV right. at Walmart? And I'd be like, nah, they ain't me. I've had a couple of those, but I never had like, you know, somebody take out a car loan in my name or something like that and show up my credit card. Luckily, I haven't had that yet, but man, all I can do is monitor. But yo, on the internet, privacy is just like, I don't really think there's anything private. Like whatever I'm looking at, all the weird like Pornhub categories I'm into, like, hey, somebody out there looking at that stuff. Ryan, yours too, man. I know you've been, you know, into some weird stuff, dog.
Nah, son. So I'm gonna say, man, it's one of those issues where you gotta give a little bit to get. If we want this world where everything is connected, everybody is connected, we can do everything from the toilet seat, then for the most part, you're going to have to be able to give that information over and have them be able to access it. Similar to what you said, Ish, if you're using that app, yeah, they do need access to your emails because they would need to check those emails, get those numbers for the invoices, et cetera, so they can call the stores and do all that work. So in that case, you have to do it. Dealing with my job, I deal with a lot of medical information and things like that. And like today I had a dude ask me, he said, I'm at the pharmacy and they want to know my social security number. And I'm like, yeah, you at the pharmacy. How else are they going to know who you are? Right. Like, you don't have a choice, man. Like, you know, and I get tired of talking to people like that. Like, you old if you think you ain't got to give your number out. You're going to have to. Now, yeah. I ain't saying go down to the flea market and give somebody your social security number, because that's not the way it's supposed to work. But if you're dealing with an entity that you know and technically trust, I mean, they're going to probably ask for some information at some point in time. Now, that doesn't make you safe. I, too, have gotten my our information stolen with the Target breach. A couple years ago. Yep. So I had a year of credit monitoring. I just did sign up myself sometime this week. I re-upped, and it basically just sends me an alert, and to be honest, I haven't even looked at it. No. I get the alerts, and I looked at it the first 10 times, but then I was like, this is stupid. Like, I can't keep on looking at this. Nothing's on here.
Word, it'd be like all you added like $12 to your balance, like a balance. Like, man, I ain't gotta log into the site, this exactly. two-factor authentication to go through all this yeah. mess. Like, nah, man, get up out of here. But yo, what this story tells me though is that Ish's email is where it goes down, fellas. That's where. So if you want the dirt on Ish, it's definitely spicy in his emails. I can tell you that my emails are dry as hell because ain't nothing going down there. It's just nothing but talking about work and. Right. And boring discussions with family. That's all that's going down in my email. So it's steal what you want, because I don't even want to read those emails anyway, fellas.
Now, on a broader side of it, though, if you really want to go, I think we're never going to be able to for everything to be private. The problem really lies in when your identity is stolen, why can that not be fixed easily? Like, we need a government entity that really gets into that. And I'm not talking about Social Security Administration, because they're not doing nothing. I mean, for real, like, identity theft where they go back and fix it. You shouldn't have to get all this insurance. I know now my job is starting to offer insurance for identity theft, and they'll pay up to this amount to try to fix it, blah, blah, blah. We are citizens of the United States, and this is how everybody does business. That needs to be something that's automatically available to each and every one of us that has a Social Security number.
Yeah, word. I've heard like it. You know, if you do get your identity stolen, like, you know, people start opening up things in your name, things like that. Like,
you're screwed.
Well, you're not screwed. You basically got to go through the credit bureaus, but it's three separate ones, and so you might have to. You know, I think there's a way to deal with, like, hopefully it's streamlined where you deal with one and they kind of reduce it, but you might have to contact all three, and that's a headache. Like, who wants to call the same people three times? You know, same different. You know, what you think is the same person, but it's really three different entities, and have the same discussion three times and have them do the same same thing three times. That's just inefficient and wasteful. You know what I'm saying? So
no, I haven't looked lately. I'm
definitely feeling on some kind of way to do it, but it's I don't even believe all that, like, you know, that man, what's that service that like offers, you know, like all lifetime protection for your credit score?
Lifelock.
Man, I ain't believing that mess. Get that mess out of here. I know that mess does not really work, man.
That guy ended up getting his
stolen.
His credit got hacked. He used to have his social security number plastered all over billboards.
Yeah, that was his big thing when he first started. Yep. Yeah. He would put his name out, like, my name is, you know, John Brown, and my social security number is, you know, 1234567 89, and then he put it out there, and he's like, I'm protected by LifeLock, and somebody stole that mess.
Right. Well, I mean, at some point it's gonna happen to you. Now it's the problem is whether or not you can catch it, and when you catch it, resolve it quickly. I mean, it's going to happen, just like our cards getting stolen, and when our debit cards get stolen, and they send you a new card, and, you know, you're fine after that.
See, but of the Black delegation, Ryan, you're the one that really needs to worry, because you got the most generic name. It could be any race or ethnicity. I mean, when I hear Ryan, I'm not going to say your last name, when I hear your last name, and I hear your full name, I know your full name, you know I do. Like that, I look at that and I was like, man, that's a 750 credit score right off top. But see, like, you talking about me and
they're gonna be very surprised.
Because when you see me and Ish's like full names on a piece of paper, you're like, oh man, that's probably a 520. That's a 5495. So like, ain't nobody stealing that mess.
We ain't gonna bother that.
Whenever
my card got compromised in the Target thing, which happened like twice. Actually, one was Target, I think one was a grocery store, but the people went to like Family Dollar. So that's what they knew. They saw my name. They're like, we could probably get something from Family Dollar. We're not about to go to Target. We're not about to go to Walmart.
Right. Word.
Right.
We not yo, going wife, to the car.
My wife had somebody go to like get $100 worth of gas or something like that. So they must have filled up 2-3 cars with that.
Yo, but you know what the things that trips me out is like when you go to like a restaurant or a store and it'd be like I never signed the back of my credit cards. I probably should, but I never signed it. But sometimes they want to like compare or they want to look at your ID.
You
to
really
make
think
sure
they do that?
Right,
you
know. Right.
Yeah, no, but it's rare that people do it. But when they do it, like I'm always like whenever that happens, they want to check my ID to make sure it matches with my name on my credit card. You know, it's kind of few and far between. But whenever they do that, I'm like, do you think if I had a stolen credit card, I'd be in here buying like some cookies and some Cheez-Its and a thing of eggs? If I had a stolen credit, like look, unless you guys selling TVs up at like the 55-inch curve TV, I'm not going to jail for some cookies and some cheese and some half and half coffee creamer. I'm not doing that, dog. I'm going to Best Buy. Check my photo ID every time at Best Buy. At the grocery store, don't do it, please.
Right.
Yeah, criminals have gone to jail for less.
Word. Yeah.
The last thing I'll say, we don't have to go into discussion, but you know, when it comes to like companies with your location, because you know, with the phones now, phones tracking everything on us. So especially location, and of course they're selling that to advertisers. And I was listening to, I think it was a Daily New York Times podcast, and they were talking about like how much access they have to you and your location. So they basically can like track what you're doing, where you're going, all through the apps on your phone. So they were saying they were like tracking the mayor's movements based on what he was doing on his phone and when he accessed this app and that app. And that's the part that gets a little scary, which me, look, I'm a person, I do the same stuff. I go to work, I go hoop, I go to church. Like, that's about it. That's my circle. Right. But for people who do want that privacy, like, you're not getting it in today's age between Google and Apple and these other companies. Like, all your business is out there.
Yeah, if you want privacy, you need to just get off the grid. No credit cards, no bank account. You don't have nothing. No job. Just be homeless. Because that's the only way you're going to get off.
Just
you,
be homeless.
You have to be homeless. Otherwise, there's a way to track you, and that's all to it. So we just have to realize if this is the world you want to live in, this is how you got to do it.
Yeah, I used to kind of think like that. Like, oh, man, I don't want to. I try to disable all the tracking. So, like, man, at this point, I don't care, man.
You haven't got no time for that.
Look, man, if I done enough weird things and nobody's come after me and I've had my location services on, like, I'm straight, man. Like, I think that's a problem with this, with society, America in general. Like, we all think too much of ourselves. Like, we think, like, oh, people care about, like, what we do. and what we doing, and what, nobody cares about the mundane tasks you're doing. Nobody cares that, you know, like, you know, that Ish is going to hoop, and hey, right before that, he's, you know, looking at ESPN scores, or, you know, checking out some, you know, some big booty thoughts on IG. Like, nobody's really caring that much, man. Right. Like, it's just not going down. So people, stop thinking that you're special. Like,
yeah, you're not. Nobody cares. Nobody cares.
Right. So, now, so just live with it.
I did have a situation yesterday where I was looking for some Christmas gifts for my oldest daughter, and I went on the website. I did not log in. I didn't click nothing. It asked me, it popped up, and it said, do you want to sign up? And I was like, no, I X'd out of that. I looked to see if they had gift cards, and I was going to order her a gift card. I get off. I immediately get an email like, hey, we saw you just visited my site. Did you? And I'm like, what is this? I've never seen anything like that before.
Nope, that's advertisers do that, or basically websites do that now, where they can pull your information when you go on the site, and they'll send you an email, or sometimes it'll pop up as like a chat box or something, even if you go to another page. So that happens, and of course, I'm sure y'all both experienced where you've been talking about something, maybe not 100%. Even searching on your phone, and then all of a sudden you start getting served ads for that. Now, right. Google and Apple say, hey, we're not listening to you, but that's definitely facts, because that happened to me a couple of weeks ago. Was delivering some laptops to these kids, and I was talking about, it was Lenovo laptop, and I was talking, the people were asking me, oh, what type of laptops are these? I was explaining, you know, why I bought them, and, you know, what type of laptops they were and whatever, and as soon as I left, I just got Lenovo ads for, like, the next 3 days. I never searched it.
Wow.
I just had a conversation about it, and that's then I started getting those ads.
Hey, real talk, I like it. I like it. Like, look, man, I want to do as least amount of work as possible. If you got a good deal for me, let me know what it is, because evidently I'm looking for it anyway. You just saved me a bunch of time. So if my phone listening right now, send me some information about some gift cards for an 18-year-old girl.
Pause.
I'm trying to get some gift cards and get out of this. Gift cards and get out.
Right.
I just said my daughter, man. Are y'all serious right now?
Explain that a little more.
Hey, you know, that's all it's on my phone anyway.
Yeah, hey.
Nah, it's going to give me nothing but advertisement with 18-year-old girls.
Right. Hey, my homie, he said he's a Jordan head, and he said that he thought that...
Oh, man, those Concords. Oh, give me those.
I got those. But he said that he always thought that when he would get Jordan ads, he thought that was God telling him, like, he need to buy these shoes, because he was like, I want these Jordans, and he didn't realize it when he would search for them that would automatically pop up. So he'd be like, man, I'm starting to get all these ads. That mean I need to cop. So I was bugging up.
Did he not pay the electric bill?
I've been getting that. Oh man, those Concords. Take me back. Those are the greatest shoes of all time. I've been seeing those come out. And I'm like, man, I want those bad.
I had to get them on this one.
See, man, that takes me back to a time and place. But yeah, man. Anyway, let's move on.
How much do those cost?
I love those shoes.
Whew. Too much.
All right, 150, 160 now, right?
220. Too much.
Yeah, 220. Ain't bad now.
Man, I'm trying to remember how much they were back in the day. Like, because I had those in college.
Are they the high top or the low top?
I had two pairs of those.
The high top ones?
The patent leathers. Yeah.
Well, I know they got some a low top version. I'll be seeing some kids wearing them sometime. Them mugs up.
Yeah, that's trash.
Okay. I ain't never had them, but I always wanted them.
Yeah, they just like the originals, except they got 45 on the heel instead of 23.
Look, I still had the originals until a couple of years ago, and I finally just gave them away to my nephews, man, because I never wore them, man. And they were just sitting in boxes. So I had a black pair, I had the all black and blue, and I had the black and white, you know, the classics. I just gave them away to my little nephews.
See, that's
man.
Why you need to go to you need to go to church, player, because you could have put on some Jordans, some patent leather Jordans with your suit, and rock them up to church.
I ain't that swaggy.
Hey, and since we're talking about this. I'll go into a brief story on how I got them, because I was like, that's really the only Jordan that I would come out of retirement for. I used to cop Jordans in this net, and I kind of got away from that. But I was like, if the Concords come back, I got to get them. So
the tens are the other one, but I'm 100% with you on that ish. But the tens are a close second. Nice the tens.
I was on my way to hoop. I kind of pulled over to the side of the road. You know, now Nike does it through their app, the sneakers app, or you could go on the website. But it's like back in the day, it used to be a situation where if you're buying online, like as soon as the time hits, you try to get it, and either it goes in your cart and you can purchase it, or it just kind of freezes up and nothing happens. And then, you know, okay, the site crashed. I couldn't get them. I didn't get it, whatever. But now they put you like in a line. I think it's almost like a little lottery. Like whoever in the first whatever 5-10 minutes that purchases, it'll like say, okay, you're in line. Let's wait and we'll see if you got it. And so you got to wait for like 3 or 4 minutes until you know whether you got the shoe or not. So I'm sitting on the side of the road like waiting for it to say whether I got it or I didn't. And so when that mug said you got it, I swear it was like I just hit the shot at game 7, boy. I was like, yes, yes, yes. So that was a thrill to get that shoe, to spend that $220 on some shoes I had junior year in high school. But like Paul said, that's kind of the holy grail for me. So I was like, I got to get these again.
Man, I want some of the Space Jam.
Now I'm retired.
Man, when I saw that shoe in that first commercial or whatever came out, man, I was like, I got it. Like, yo, I got to get that. I'm standing in line. Everybody's standing in line. That was a moment right there, man. That's just, but there never been a shoe before or like that since, right, man. It's like, you really, whoever that dude, whatever Tinker, whatever his name was, that was designing all those shoes for Jordans, you know, Nike and Jordan back then.
He did all
man.
Them joints, though, man. That dude was just a genius. Moment.
Dude's a genius, man. But you know, just, like, that was just iconic. Yeah. You can't really... I don't think you can make some nice shoes, I'm sure, but you just can't recreate that moment right, there. Right. You try to recreate that, and you end up with that Kobe Adidas moon boot shoe that he had.
them shoes south, people will be rocking them.
Although,
now.
Real talk, man. Yeah, look, that shoe, that Kobe shoe, that moon shoe that I joke on, like that Adidas shoe. If that was out today, that would be a big, big seller. That exact ugly butt shoe would be a big seller. Just change the colorway, and it would do money. Speaking of that, man, when I was over in Europe last week, man, so I'm over in Europe, man. The kids, that's what they wear, man. They wear these clunky, chunky shoes, and I saw more. I mean, I was gonna take some pics and send it to you, Ryan. I saw more than 4, 5, 6 young, you know, kind of like hipster teenagers over there in Europe, rocking the Monarchs, man. They were rocking Monarchs, like with for swag. Not old man, not some old man just walking around with Monarchs on over there in Europe. Just these were young, 15, 16 year old dudes trying to swag with Monarchs on. I mean, they like those chunky shoes, man. It's crazy. I don't understand it, but that's the way the kids are going.
I mean, even here, like, quote unquote dad shoes are the style right now. So that's what everybody is starting to get. So, you know, Nike is starting to make some. Under Armour has
I think all the Kanye's are.
Yeah, everybody's starting to make these dad shoes now.
Yeah. That's because everybody realized now that your feet need to be comfortable and it's important. That's all to it. You get you some of them old schools, man, your feet will be comfortable. But that ain't me, not yet. I still just rock Air Max exclusively, although I found me some KD8s the other day for very, very cheap. And so cop them. Very comfortable shoes. Feel like I'm walking on a mattress.
Yep, that's what it gets to.
Nasty. That's nasty.
You said what?
The older you get, that comfort.
Definitely. All right, so what else? What else we got?
It's the holiday time.
Did we ever do the cheap delegates? We were supposed to talk about which one of us was the cheapest.
Bro, we could do a whole show. We could do 3 shows on this topic right here.
We were supposed to talk about who was the cheapest. I'm still voting for Paul as the cheapest delegate. Just got Netflix, bro, because you've been so cheap. You said $10.99 a month. Like, I'm not paying that. And I was like, dude, like, your wife is a stay-at-home mom. How she don't have Netflix?
bro, we just don't watch TV. Like I just don't have time. That's like that. Torture. So like, but I've had it for now. I've had Netflix for like 3-4 years. But yeah, I remember when you were trying to get you. I like get on it, then I'd cancel it after like 3 months. I was like, man, I never watch it. And legit, man, I've had it. I probably had it straight for the last 2 years, and I've probably been on there like 4 or 5 times in the last like 6 months, man. I just never on. Every time I go on there, it's always me searching for what I want to see, and I just like. And I just never, and I spend like 30 minutes just looking for something like, ooh, I want to see that. Okay, which one's better than that? And then I'd never watch anything. That's it,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, that's what it is until you start watching
what
something.
What about your wife?
No,
does your
watch
wife
it? No,
watch
no,
it?
No,
yeah,
no.
She do.
She doesn't. She doesn't.
She tell you she don't. Well, she ain't just sitting home doing the taxes every day. She got to do something.
Man,
she can't tell you what she doing. She kicking it.
I'm she, here most of the time, right, man. I know what's right. going on, but yo.
Let's go on that right. Netflix history. Let's call up the internet privacy folks and see what's
right.
really
but,
going
on.
See
how in many spirit, African I'm, romances I am she watched. I'm probably the cheapest, but in reality, I just spend tons of money for no reason, man. Oh God, I can get into some more stories about this from last week, but I won't do that to you guys.
I ain't the cheapest, I don't think, but I think I'm. I've learned the ways of being frugal.
Mm.
Because of me being out of work that one time for like 18 months, I was out of work for so long that it became a hustle to try to get the things that I needed.
Ryan,
so I was
hitting
up every thrift store imaginable.
Fam, come on, bro. We were in college as freshmen going to McDonald's. We told the story before going to get the 29-cent cheeseburgers and the 19.
That ain't because we was cheap. That's because we was broke.
What's the difference?
There's a big difference.
I don't think so, man. That's some struggle burgers right there, man.
Dog, we had to decide whether or not we wanted to eat that. So those hamburgers being 29 cents, let us eat
for a whole week, man. We eating terrible McDonald's, man. Can you imagine what happened to our stomachs because of that, man? And doing that
absolutely
week,
nothing. Because life was good when you were young.
You don't get diarrhea when you're poor.
Nope. Ran for days.
Anyway,
what about you, Ish? What's some? Are you cheap, man? I don't know if I would say that you cheap.
Well, that's the thing. I was gonna say before you said what you said. I was gonna say I'm probably the brokest out of the bunch, but I don't think that I'm the cheapest. So, you know, it's certain things where I'm sure you know my wife calls me cheap. My wife thinks I'm cheap. So there are a lot of things I don't want to waste money on. You know, I came from. Humble time growing up, so you couldn't waste a whole lot. So I don't like to be wasteful, but at the same time, if it's something that I really want, then I'll spend the money. I don't mind spending the money on. Like I said, I just bought the Concords. Like that's something that's not cheap,
right?
But it's something that I wanted. I was like, let me go ahead and splurge on this. Also, I bought a phone today. I bought a new cell phone today.
Look at this guy.
Ordered that. It was something I wanted. Now, I don't go and do that often, but when I see, so, okay, I want this. I'm about to need a new phone. Now, my phone is still working fine. It slowed down a little bit. I didn't have to have a phone, but I wanted a phone, so I went ahead and I spent the money for it. But that's just kind of, I don't know, few and far between. If I want it, I'm going to get it, but I'm not going to waste money just to be
fam, wasteful. When I buy a phone, just know.
Or I'm gonna try to get deals.
Ryan, just know when I buy a phone, just know that something happened to that old phone. That phone went in the toilet. Somebody threw it across
See,
the room.
That's why you're the cheapest delegate.
My wife looked at my browser history. Something like that happened. I'm in trouble. So I had to go buy one.
Didn't Paul say he had it? Paul said he had an iPhone 5.
I got a 7, man. I'm good. I got a 7, man.
Oh, see, he's moving on up.
And he just got that one.
No, I've had it for a while, man. But I did buy it refurbished because that's how I'm thrifty, man. I'm thrifty like that.
Hey, you and me got that in common. I am not afraid to buy anything used. Matter of fact, I want to look at it used first. I hate when Christmas come around because I feel like I can't buy nothing used no more. I'm losing all value. My wife and them was like, "Oh, we need some new Uggs," and I was like, "You know how much I can get Uggs for on the used side." Some real cheap. Right. You can get them real cheap because some rich person is like, I don't want these no more. Get some Uggs for $60 instead of $200.
Man, word.
But I can't do it. I got to find some new ones.
Tough times, man. Tough times.
But yeah. But other than that, man, I guess that's really That's really it on that.
We had to get a little deeper into that. I can go for days on that subject, man. About stuff I've done to save a dollar here and there. It doesn't always work out, but man, we can shelve that for another day.
Do you drive around looking for the cheapest gas station?
Hell to the no.
Okay. No. Anybody that do that, you tripping. Because that's a waste of time.
But now you don't got to do that. Now that's what Apple's
It's still
for
the same
now,
thing, so though. But you still drive.
Because you waste time.
I don't do that. I see, like, well, I don't know. You guys might have this situation. I don't know. Because you guys are close to, like, a border. So, like, I live, like, really, really close to a different state. So, like, the neighborhood I live in, like, literally four or five, maybe 3 miles away is South Carolina. So what the general rule is that the prices for gas and stuff and groceries are cheaper in South Carolina. So like the Walmart I go to a lot is in South Carolina, and a lot of times if I'm out that way, I'll get gas over there, and it's a bit cheaper than what it is in North Carolina.
How much cheaper you gonna get at Walmart, bro? It's rollback prices. Ain't it the same?
No, man. Like the Walmart in North Carolina.
Besides taxes.
Man, like they got milk over there for like 50 cents a gallon or something like that. Man, it's crazy. What? I'm not kidding. Like, no, man, it's like $1.03 or something like that. But then like in on North Carolina, same gallon of milk at the Walmart in North Carolina, it's like whatever 170 or 180 or something like that. So it's okay. There's a material difference, man. I just come down here and show you one day. But the gas is a good 20 some cents cheaper. So whenever I'm over there, I just do it. But I don't ever like, oh, I'm going to find this one place or that one place. It's just kind of like, okay, over here, I know it's a little cheaper. I'll do that. That's it.
We ain't got no help here on the gas because, across the state border, Illinois is even more.
That's because they broke. Yeah, they need money.
All right, Christmas season. Okay, let's do some Christmas songs. I need some Christmas music to start this joint off with, but we'll do it as we go on. So, I wanted to talk about what y'all favorite Christmas songs are because, of course, it's that time of year, so around Thanksgiving, every single store was playing Christmas songs. And the other day, I was in an antique shop, and they was playing one of my favorite Christmas jams. And I was like, let me put this on the list for us to talk about. What's your favorite Christmas songs? What's the blackest Christmas song? And what's the whitest Christmas songs in y'all's opinion? So, Ishmael, you haven't talked in a while. So, if you want to, you can go first.
Well, let's see. I think my favorite Christmas song is probably also the blackest Christmas song.
Okay.
And that would be Silent Night, the Temptations version.
Okay, yeah, that's a classic. Now,
for me, it ain't Christmas if I don't get to hear Silent Night, the Temptations version. Not the regular version. The regular version, you know, you can miss me with that. I can take it or leave it. But that Temptations Christmas song, I just remember every Christmas over my grandma's house, she used to have that bumping. Family used to be together. So for me, yeah, Silent Night, Temptations, that is my favorite, and that is the blackest Christmas song.
All right, blackest Christmas song. So that's your favorite black one. Do you have a favorite white Christmas song?
I don't know. That's a good question. I had to think about that.
Okay, we'll come back to it.
For some strange reason, I like We Three Kings. Like,
really?
Some weird way.
That song is trash. Song. But I get it. When you little, like, it's a cool story. But when you really listen to it, that song is trash. It's not in the rotation.
Right.
What about you, Paul?
Yo, blackest song is 100%. And Ish, I can't believe you whiffed on this. Look, man, don't invite me to your Christmas at the Ish household, man. I'm not going. If that's the number one song, it's definitely Donny Hathaway, This Christmas.
That's a fact.
Blackest Christmas song of all time. Air horns. It's smooth.
Air horns.
Give me my air horn, man. That's the right answer. 100%. Whatever answer you just gave, that is wrong. It's not even close, dog. So that's 100% the blackest Christmas song. Now, as for the whitest Christmas song, and I'm gonna get some pushback. Whatever goodwill I've just built up with my last answer, I'm gonna get some pushback on this one. The whitest Christmas song is 100% Nat King Cole, chestnuts roasting on open fire. Whatever that. I'm fully aware Nat King Cole is extra crispy black. That is still the whitest Christmas song ever. I don't want to hear it. Get that mess out of here. I don't want to hear Nat King Cole slow crooning about talking about some fire. Get up out of here. Give me some Donny Hathaway. Give me some Luther Vandross. The whole Luther Vandross CD. You can just hit play on that joint. And for what it's worth, man. Hey, I know she crazy, but Mariah Carey, man. Hey, that lady can, whatever you think. She can do her thing and she can sing. And that album is timeless. You can put that whole Mariah Carey Christmas CD and just let it run, and the whole house is gonna be grooving. Black, white, brown, whoever you invite over, they're gonna be cool with that CD. The Luther Vandross 100%. And the worst Christmas song. Let me just get my whole list out here. Can I do that, fellas?
Oh, you gonna go with the worst?
Worst. Okay. Go ahead. Worst Christmas song is that Santa Baby, Eartha Kitt. Get that mess out. That is the 1940s.
It's a cool song.
That's the 1940s THOT anthem. That is basically City Girls. That's basically Cardi B. That's Nicki Minaj song for Christmas 1940s.
And
chicks.
Why is there a problem with that? I don't understand why.
I have a problem with that. I don't want to hear no City Girls.
If she was twerking and it was a video, you wouldn't have a problem with it.
Man, get that mess out of here. Look, right. get them gold diggers out there.
THOT celebrate Christmas too, okay?
Yeah. That's a side chick anthem. Get that mess out of here. I don't want to hear it.
Side chick anthem.
The lyrics. That's a side chick anthem. So now, Ryan, I want to hear yours, but then we got to get into this. Did y'all hear about the topic about this Christmas song that they stopped playing? I forgot the name of the song. They stopped playing it now because they said the lyrics are too Baby, It's Cold Outside. They stopped playing that now on radio.
Oh, I didn't read it. I didn't read it, but I saw it.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll let's hear the song. Maybe we can talk about that later.
All right. So I'm gonna go favorite blackest, and then I'm gonna do favorite whitest. So my favorite Christmas song. And this just came up. I'm not going to use the same. I would probably say Donny Hathaway, like Paul said, this Christmas. Probably my favorite Christmas song of all time. But a recent number two. I actually had to text my wife and say, you know what? This song right here is banging. Last Christmas by Wham. That song beats right now. Let me play a little bit of it.
And you know who's in there, right? You know who's in there. Yeah.
You heard that song? Yeah. Let me get to the chorus. I know you heard it, man. This song is a jam.
It's a staple. It's a Christmas staple.
Yeah, this song is a jam, dog.
But it's got that 80s new wave to it. Yeah.
I know you heard it before. Yeah. But, dog, if you listen to that whole song, after about 2 minutes, you're going to be like, man, like, this song is dope. And I finally was like, you know what? I got to find out who even sings this song. I don't know. So I went ahead and Shazammed it. Last Christmas by Wham. He gave her his heart. And the next day she gave it away. It's deep.
You know who that is, though, right?
Wham. That's what it says.
But you know who Wham is, right?
No, I don't know who that is.
It's George Michael. That's George Michael.
Oh, word? Okay. Yeah, that's what's up. Okay. Shout out to George Michael.
Shout out to George Michael. Oh, man, right. Let me tell you, my wife hates Feliz Navidad. And so I might have to divorce her because of this, man. She hates Feliz Navidad. I can't rock with that, man. She hates Feliz Navidad. We got like this little Christmas CD for the kid. And so that's one of the songs on there. Every time it comes on, she just, that's auto skip for her. And I'm like, I like that song. She's like, no, we ain't listening to that. I don't like that. And I'm like, man, just getting overruled in the car. And she just totally ignores the Feliz Navidad, man. So.
After she skipped it, did she like say build a wall?
She reaches in the glove compartment, pulls out the MAGA hat, throws it on, looks at me, and just like, what you gonna do?
What?
Just rides on. And I'm like, man.
Okay. So my favorite blackest Christmas song ever, Santa Claus is Coming to the Ghetto on the Death Row Christmas album. I can't believe y'all didn't say it. That is the blackest Christmas song ever created. Ever.
Hey, Christmas and Hollis. That's my joint right there. That's
yeah,
forever.
Yeah, but that's
we played.
Tone. That's tame in comparison. To Santa Claus Coming to the Ghetto, which Daz murdered his verse on there as well.
That means Daz did not write that. Then that means.
Now I don't know what Snoop was doing. His first verse was whack, but then his second verse was cool. he did a little Silk the Shocker impression on that first verse. But here we go. Now, I wasn't sure which white song I wanted to pick as the whitest Christmas song in my opinion.
You just played it 2 minutes ago.
No, not Wham. It's not the whitest. It's not the whitest. That song got some soul, that last Christmas. But these songs, the whitest Christmas song, I'm going to have to say, is Holly Jolly Christmas.
Yeah.
That have good. A holly jolly Christmas. Like, that song is so white. I love it. I like it because it is on my list. But it was either that or Here Comes Santa Claus by Gene Autry. I didn't know. I had to look up his name. I wasn't sure who he is. I know y'all heard that. Here comes Santa Claus. Here comes Santa Claus. That song is whack.
Hey,
whack.
Hey, no, can I on the low though? You know what? White Christmas song. Super white Christmas song. I do dig is Jingle Bell Rock. Man, the original version of Jingle Bell Rock is dope. That's kind of fire, man. That's some swag for 1940s, man.
That knock a little bit.
Now, so what's up with these new people? Are they doing Christmas songs? Can we get a new Christmas joint? Who doing Christmas songs?
Yeah, I don't know.
Can we get a Cardi B Christmas?
Song
Migos,
I got to mention.
Migos Christmas.
The Migos Christmas.
I would be down for a Migos Christmas album.
No,
I said that last year, but I'm down for it.
One song I got to mention that I thought one of y'all might, but you didn't. So
he's just trying to save himself from his terrible answer earlier.
No. Not at all, because that is still the blackest Christmas song. Y'all's was good. I rock with y'all's too. But also, Jackson 5, I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus, as also a dope and a very black Christmas song. So
it's pretty dope.
But that's pretty dope. Y'all are both wrong when it comes to the whitest Christmas song.
What's the whitest?
Very sad and disappointed in both of you for your answers. It's very obvious. It's not rocket science. The whitest Christmas song is White Christmas. What are y'all doing?
Yeah, I thought that was pretty obvious, man. I didn't want to go with that.
Look at the lyrics, man. I found the deleted lyrics from the last verse that it got cut out sometime.
There's a last verse?
Oh, there's like a clan rally.
We had to find a way for the black people to get dissed.
There's a last verse, a lost verse, you know, probably around the 60s. They cut it out. They said, no, this is too much. They're going to march. They're going to riot. They're going to tear up. And that verse says, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones with no Negroes.
No, it's
when
not,
the
man.
Treetops glisten after a good lynching, then ring slave bells in the snow.
Did you write this, man? Yo.
That's the verse, like, man. That's the lost verse,
it is
bro.
Not. This is like the Jingle Bells, Batman smells we all used to do back in fifth grade. This is like the communist version.
Man.
That's what they sing at the White House.
You sang that hard too.
That's what they sing at the White House.
I crack jokes on Ish, but Ish got the voice, man. He just want to get those bars off, just for the lady listeners. That's all it was. Right, he just want to get that. Right. He just want to get his little Van Gogh on out there. Yeah,
you're welcome. Man, I want to throw out an honorable mention if I can. Y'all remember the song from the Home Alone soundtrack? The song that they have on all those commercials when white people are giving out Lexuses for Christmas. I think that's anytime you giving out a car for Christmas, first of all, very white. But the fact that that song is the one that they pick, super white. Ain't nobody getting, don't buy me something that I got to pay a monthly note on for Christmas. I'm just saying. But if it ain't paid in full, I don't want it.
Yeah, that's what.
And
that's
then
the
put
point
a big old bow on top of the hood.
Yeah,
and
put
and
a bow.
That makes it okay.
That's something Paul be doing. Paul, you be putting bows on these cars, man. That's how you do it.
Man,
that's
I ain't buying. Doing it. Look, first of all, I ain't buying no car. I don't want to buy a car, and if I do, I'm definitely not putting a bow on it. Look, that's the car, man. You don't put no big ass bow on this thing. I gotta throw this mess away. Hey, but yo, for real, I wasn't even hip to the Luther Vandross Christmas CD until I started hanging with my wife's family. They play it like every Christmas go over there, and so like that. But that's probably like my favorite overall Christmas CD to listen to. Now it's ingrained in my brain, so I have to throw that on. In fact, we had it on last night, so I have to throw it on again tomorrow too.
I don't know if I've listened to it. I'm gonna have to because I like the some Luther, like
blackness,
some
black. Well,
you know, well, you said you hadn't heard it either. So,
This was like 10 years ago. I hadn't heard it, or 15 years ago. But, you know, just over, I was kind of like, oh, yeah, what is that? You know, and then over just every year they'd always had, that was like what, their Christmas CD. They just play it over and over and over again every time I go over there. So then I've heard
it. Is it original songs or he just singing Christmas songs?
A couple of, most of them are, I'd say about half and half original and some are standards. But, I mean, it's just Luther Vandross. I forgot what it's called, you know, whatever. Just look up Luther Vandross Christmas. It's actually on my YouTube music. I just play it off there. We just streaming on Wi-Fi. But it's a fire CD, man.
Yo, I gotta get that Jackson 5 Christmas joint, man. I think that might even be the Holy Grail. I forgot about Santa Claus is Coming to Town off of there.
Oh, that's trash. That's trash, man. Nobody want to hear 4-year-old Michael Jackson with his little kid voice, man. Nobody want to hear the Chipmunks. I want to hear grown men singing.
Oh, man, you're in violation. You hating on Michael. You hating on Eartha. I don't know, man. I don't know. Your Christmas
Eartha
might be canceled.
Eartha is a goat, but she's still a thought. That's all that matters.
That's gonna be the title of the show. Eartha is a thought. All right, and on that note, we're going to close it out.
Hey, let's end on the
Enjoyed the episode. Good. It was not much work, which is even better, and it was more just us talking.
Right.
So, hopefully we can do this more often. Next week, probably going to be a chill episode. Maybe we could do favorite Christmas movies or something. Or, I don't know. We'll think about it, though.
Yeah, but before listeners, let us know, what is your favorite Christmas song? We need to know. Yep. We told you ours. We want to know, what do you rock with on the holidays? What song makes or breaks Christmas for you? So hit us up on Twitter or Instagram at Black Delegates. There's an underscore between Black and Delegates. You can leave us on our Facebook page, or you could email us at theblackdelegatespod@gmail.com. If you want to follow Ryan on Twitter, he is at @TheBlackRyan. If you want to follow Paul, he is at Boxed Wine Papi, or you can follow me on Twitter or Instagram at Ish Creates Paul. People want to help out the pod. They want to give us a Christmas gift. What can they do?
Yo, rate us and review us and tell a friend. That's what we want you to do.
Hit me on a Cash App, player. That's what you can do for me. Merry Christmas to all.
Right. I guess that's a wrap. Deuces.
Yep, that's a wrap. Right, I'm looking at the behind the lyrics on Last Christmas. Michael told CNN, I want people to know that the songs I wrote back then about women are about women. There is no BS there. So shout out to Wham. I'm going to play it out. Play it out. Mm-hmm. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. The very next day, you give it away. Give it to somebody to tell me something. It's pretty what? It's a jam. It's a jam player.
Ryan, I want you to look up. I want you to look up Wham. Wham's other big song, "Wake Me Up Before You Go."
Oh, "Wake Me Up Before You Go Go" is a jam too. What you talking, man? I'm about to get on Wham.
But have you seen the video? Like, you will turn gay if you watch that video.
I truly won't watch it.
No, please watch. I want you to watch it this over the week, next week, and report back on
okay,
how you felt
I'll
after
do
this.
That. All right. So, good night, everybody.
Peace.
Peace.